Hello, welcome back to ASP.NET MVC tutorial. I am Ashish. So this is my fifth tutorial. So before proceeding, I would like to suggest you to watch my previous videos, because in this tutorial I am just going to use that example which I have previously used. So now I'm going to just discuss about the difference between ViewBag, ViewData and TempData. So you might be knowing that this is very popular question and asked in every interview. So now come to ViewData and ViewBag. So it is used to pass data from controller to corresponding view. ViewData is the dictionary object that is derived from ViewDataDictionary classes. ViewBag is the dynamic container. It can store string, list or int. So just data type is decided on the fly. ViewData require typecasting and ViewBag doesn't require typecasting. So here you can see the syntax. ViewBag.MyName equal to Ashish. ViewData in bracket MyName is equal to Ashish. And now come to TempData. TempData is also a dictionary object derived from TempDataDictionary. It helps to maintain data when you move from one controller to another controller or one action to another action. Now we will discuss it practically. Now you can see the syntax TempData MyName. Now come to the controller. So in the previous session I was just created a controller, and now you can see the classes. I have just created employee class having this attribute, and now I have just created a list of that employee and passing to the view. And if you go to view, then you will see I have just binded it. And now if you run it, then you will see a list of employee, its ID and its name and its department. Here you go. Okay, now I'm going to controller, and now I'm going to use ViewBag, ViewData and TempData instead of this model. So I'm gonna delete it. And now I'm gonna use this. So I already have created this. So let's comment it. We will discuss it further and use only ViewBag. So I'm going to use ViewBag. Copy. And instead of model, you can use, I'm just going to use this ViewBag. And now let's run this project and let's see what's gonna happen here. So as you know, ViewBag is a dynamic container. So I have just inserted a list inside a ViewBag. So it just dynamically checked it data type at the runtime. You can see the list. It's returning null. Okay, I have just forgot to remove this. Delete it. Now save it and put a @ sign here. Now refresh it. Now you can see the list here. And now I'm going to stop it and I'm going to controller. And now instead of ViewBag, I'm going to use ViewData here. And now when I copy it, copy, and now I'm going to paste it here. So now it will give me an error. So let's see. For each statement cannot operate on variable of type object, because object does not contain a public definition for getEnumerator. So here you need to do typecasting. So you need to tell that what data type you are going to use. So I'm going to use list of what MVC tutorial dot model dot employee. So now I'm just casting it here. So here now let's run it and let's see what's gonna happen here, whether it is giving me error or not. Now you can see the list from view data and the list from view bag and the list from model. Okay, so all of them are returning the same list, and now hence it is proved that ViewBag is a dynamic container and it doesn't require any typecasting, and ViewData require typecasting. You can see here we just typecast. Now I'm going to controller, and now I'm going to explain the temp data. So here I'm going to comment it, control K U. Okay, so in ViewBag I am just inserting a employee. Just keep it here. Okay, so in ViewBag I'm just inserting a string Mary, ViewData Ashish. I'm just it is name. You can see the name employee name VD means ViewData, employee name TD means temp data. Now I have created a second page. Now if you go to view, you can check I have just created a list, and here your view, I'm just showing all data. I'm showing the view data, temp data, view data, temp data, and view bag value here. Now here I'm going to copy it and will show at my page also, and then by redirecting it to second page, I will just show whether if the redirection occurs, then what's gonna happen with temp data, view data, and view back. Okay, so let's run this. So here on the start I am just setting view back data, view data, and temp data value, and I'm showing it beneath the list. Now here you can see your view bag value is Mary, view data, and John. And now I'm going to I'm going to redirect to this page. You can see here I'm going to second page. So let's see here you can see your view bag value is null, your view data value is null, and your temp data, all of them get null. So you don't need to be worried, because one thing is assured that both are used to pass data from controller to corresponding view. It means if redirection occur, it value get null. So both view data and view bag value will be null if redirection occur. And in same case, temp data also get null, but we have just one method, temp data dot keep. If you use this method, or you can pass your temp name ID inside it, but I am not going to use it. Okay, let's run it, and again we will go to the redirection. And now first I'm going to just empty the layout. Layout equal to null, because I'm going to discuss it in later video session. So here I'm setting up data and showing on the view. Now I'm going to second page. Now here you can see I have just used tempData.Keep. Now its value will be preserved. Okay, what happened here? Let me check tempData. Okay, now here you can see I have just used tempData.keep, then it's showing me this value. Your tempData value is, so here when redirection occur, then my tempData value gets preserved. So here you can say it helps to maintain data when you move from one controller to another controller or from one action to another action. So as you go to this page, and if redirection occur, then you can also preserve this value, tempData value, but not other value. Means like view data, it doesn't have that functionality. So view data and view back does not, if redirection occur, then it value get null. But in tempData you can preserve up to, if you know the your destination page, destination controller, then definitely you can use it. There is a layout difference, so I have just make then layout equal to null. Now I'm going to, I need to give a reference here. Here I will give it, and now you can see if I refresh it means if I refresh it, then it will be gone, because here I am not setting up, that was my final controller. So that's why the John gets vanish. And if I go to this previous page, and now from home controller, see, from home controller here, that is from index. From index I'm going to second page. So here I'm setting up tempData and tempData.keep. So that's why when I just get on second page, then this is kept. And now if I reload it, then it will be vanish, because in this method I'm just reloading this second page, and I did not write this method again here. If I write here, then definitely it's gonna work with me. So this way you can use your tempData, your view data and view back. So in this tutorial we have just discussed about the view back, view data and tempData. So thank you very much for watching me, and if you really like, then give us a thumbs up, comments and share my videos, and subscribe obviously.